standing ovation. You may now sit down. Thank you so much. Also, my gratitude to Eunice who handed me a very beautiful bouquet. Thank you so much. And of course, to Asmin, who introduced me a while ago, he was very busy and brave. Equally busy and brave with our two lovely masters of ceremony. We have Armando Jr. and Ashana. Let's give them a round of applause, please. And of course, to the masters of ceremony, teacher leader, Nias, teacher Maybel Mangunas. Maraming salamat po. And of course, before I'm going to start my speech, let me have my warmest gratitude and welcome message also to all the grade 1 and grade 2 teachers who are here with us. Palakpakan po natin silang lahat. Most especially to the Tres Marigas, the kindergarten teachers, Ma'am Angelita Kukuba, Ma'am Jennifer Abao, and to the chairman, Ma'am Janet Bungod. Palakpakan din po natin sila. And to our leaders, our master teachers, master teacher I mean, Ma'am Elilani B. Sales, our designated guidance counselor, Ma'am Janelle Ann Dilag, and of course, to our very motherly leader, our school principal, Ma'am Riza R. Valdez. To all the parents and to our queen of our program today, our movers, good morning and magandang gensan.
Wow, gensan.
Parang mahina man, good morning and magandang gensan. Yes. So I am here standing in front of you because I am representing the alumni of this school. Kids, when you say alumni, these are persons who graduated in this school. So I graduated last 1996 as grade 6 here in this school. And at this moment, I would like also to recognize all the alumni, parents, and visitors who are present today. May I request you to please stand up? So lahat po ng mga alumni, tatayo po natin yung nag-graduate na dito na parents. Mga parents, ayan, medyo madami din sila. May I request you to stay in front so that your children will be glad seeing you standing in front that ang si mama, si papa, dito pala nag-graduate sa school. Palakpakan po natin silang lahat. Ayun, medyo madami sila. So si mama, si papa, dito pala nag-graduate. Wow! Thank you for trusting the school. Ayan, mga kilala ko din ang mga mukha. Pero, medyo ano na ako, no? Ayan, meron talaga akong dalawang batch dito, dalawang kabatch. Si, ano, si Father Roger at saka si Fritzy. Thank you so much. Thank you for trusting the school and being loyal. Kahit po, nag-graduate na po tayo, you are still sending your school to where you graduated from your elementary grades. Palakpakan ulit natin ang ating mga alumni. Thank you for your support. Salamat po. And for your cooperation. Yan. And aside from standing here as an alumni, I am also wearing this costume. Do you know the character that I am portraying? Kids? Sino kaya ako? Awa, alam niyo talaga. Kala ko ano, kasi ito yung matabang version ng Cinderella. Medyo fatty kasi ako mo. So, I am Cinderella, but sad to say, my Prince Charming did not return my golden shoes. So that is why I'm wearing my black shoes with, but pero my shiny shimmering pa rin. Okay? So I am portraying the Cinderella character. Okay? And I have my wand here. Later, I will do magic. if you are going to listen to me. Okay? So I asked Cinderella, I wear this one because I want this kid to really bear in their mind and with whole heart, and mind, they can understand our theme for this moving up ceremony. Our theme is K-12 graduates pursuing dreams and fostering resilience in the face of adversity. That is Cinderella in the movie. And the Cinderella you have read in a book. You know, Cinderella experienced a very harsh and tragic thing in the hands of her stepsister and stepmother. She was really had a hard time in her life. But you know what? She did not stop dreaming. She did not lose hope. She still dreamed of a beautiful thing that might happen in her life. I want you to be Cinderella. And you have now experienced how to be a Cinderella, because we have all experienced the bad times during the pandemic. We did not lose our hopes. We did not stop dreaming. But still, we continue chasing our dreams by continuing our education. So, I was also once a Cinderella before. And thank you to the one who molded me as Cinderella. Cinderella who never stopped dreaming and hoping, because I have one person also who is with me, who are with me. One of that person is my idol teacher. And she inspired me, motivated me to become a teacher now. And she is also my co-teacher here. I would like to say thank you and to be recognized. Please stand up, Ma'am Ilelani B. Sales. She is my idol teacher. She is the one who pushed me, who encouraged me from Girl Scout to being a student and to be an excellent pupil. Thank you so much, Ma'am Ilelani B. Sales. And of course, Ma'am Emily Alconera is not here. She is also teaching in this school. And other teachers that we, yung mga tumayo kanina, have experience, already retired. So sila na lang dalawa yung naiwan dito sa school na mga veterans teacher. Thank you so much. Now, kids, have you also say thank you to your teacher? Sino na nakapag-thank you sa kanyang teacher? Beth, asang kamay? Sino na nakapag-thank you kay Ma'am Janet? Wow, very good. Sino na nakapag-thank you kay Ma'am Jennifer? Wow. How about kay Ma'am Angelita, kay Ma'am Angel, Teacher Angel? Wow, very good, kids. And for the last time, we are going to say thank you to our teachers. Can you do the heart sign? Everybody, do the heart sign. So this is the heart sign. Okay, put that on your heart. Dito sa right. Okay, and you can also do this way. Everybody, do the heart sign. The heart sign. And the heart sign. So that heart sign is a symbol of the heart, which also speaks thank you to our teacher. Palakpakan natin ang ating teachers. So thank you so much, teachers. Ma'am Angel, Teacher Jen, and Teacher Janet. You became the second mother and parent of these children. This teacher could never say no They always say yes. And that is because for the sake of our children. Thank you for your dedication and hard work. Please know that the best teacher that I adore most are the primary grade level teachers. Palakpakan po natin sila. Why? Because they exert extra time, extra effort in molding these children. The first teachers that they encounter in learning. You are such a great person. We're able to let these children be taught in their studies. We saw how you did your job well. And behind this teacher or teachers is the leader who always makes sure that what the school will offer is always the best for these children. So, let us do the salute sign, children. Do you know the salute sign? You put your four fingers here on your eyebrow. Yan, very good. That salute sign is for our principal, Ma'am Riza R. Valdez, because she is our leader. Okay? Salute down. Thank you so much. So, and of course, to the Department of Education for having programs also for these children. Now, children, in my speech just a while ago, you have heard that there are many people behind the success, okay? The success of this moving up ceremony. And they will not stop because you will still be in the next level. So they are going to plan and make things better for you. And the persons who took a big part in molding these children are the parents. Palakpakan natin ang ating mga parents, children. Mama and Papa, Mommy and Daddy, you've done a good job. Now, kids, we should say a thank you song also for our parents. So, please join me in singing our thank you song. Okay, sabay-sabay tayo ha. Thank you ever so much. Ready, sing. Thank you ever so much. Thank you ever so much. Thank you ever, thank you ever. Thank you ever so much. Okay, now I'd like you to learn a Japanese and Nihongo language of saying thank you ever so much. In Japanese, that is arigato gozaimasu. Arigato. Everybody say arigato. Arigato gozaimasu. When you say arigato, thank you lang yun. It's just a casual of saying that one. But when you respect in saying thank you say arigato gozaimasu. So we are going to sing arigato gozaimasu. Arigato gozaimasu. Ready, sing. Arigato gozaimasu. Arigato gozaimasu. Arigato, arigato. Arigato gozaimasu. Wow, palakpakan natin. Ang galing kumanta ng mga bata. And of course, that thank you song is for all the parents who are present today. And those parents who are very busy, siguro nagluluto sila sa bahay, no? O kaya busy sila sa trabaho. Thank you for your support. Thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts. We have seen how you've done your part in education, especially in educating the learners in this new normal. Thank you for unending encouragement to these children. I know it is not very easy to teach these children in answering their modules while you are having your work. I know it's not easy. But we've surpassed that. We have conquered all the trials that we have experienced. You have assisted them in the modules, in the online class, and now you are sending them and fetching them in the school. Thank you so much. But it doesn't mean that it ends there. It ends here. Because next year is another phase. And we need to level up the assistance, the support that we will give to these children. And this is to have a stronger foundation for them. And as a teacher, I want you to take this guide in assisting these children. Number one, everybody say, kids, number one. Number one, offer quality time. Quality time. Quality doesn't speak about how many hours, how many days that you have spent together with your child. Quality means the impact that you can give when you have seated with your children. That is number one. The second is, have a friendly relationship with your teachers. We need to have communication with our teachers because we need to follow up what is happening with our children. We need to catch up at home because it is our responsibility as parents to see to it that you have that follow-up in terms of the academic performance of our children so that you can catch up at home. That is number two. Everyone say number two. And everyone say number three. And the last is, you need to believe in your child. You need to believe in their capacities. Do not underestimate your children. Do not ever underestimate your children. Let them explore. Let them learn from their mistakes. Because from there, they will be able to learn. Because you are there when they are exploring, when they are learning, you are there assisting, guiding them and inspiring them to develop their potentials, their capabilities, and their abilities. So, your house is their first stage. Stage yung pinatatayuan ko ngayon. That is the first stage of the children. So, on that first stage, in your house, let them discover their talent so that when they are out from your houses, they'll be able to share their talent. Two, let others know that they are capable of doing that thing. So, that those are the three tips that I would like you to have as you go home. Kids, the stars of the day. Palakpakan po namin sila parents. Okay, now kids, can you do the thumbs up? Thumbs up? Yan. How about the girls? Can you do the thumbs up? Yan. That's thumbs up means that you are ready. Ready to become a grade one learner. Who is excited? Who is excited to be a grade one? Wow! Excited na sila mga grade one teachers. Okay, hands down. Okay? So you are now excited to be a grade one. But you need to take all my points, okay? The guides that I can give you. Kids, thank you for listening to your mother, to your father, and to the guardian that you have at home. You need to listen to your mother. respect them. Like how you enjoy watching your cartoon show. Sino ba yung favorite cartoon character nyo? Yes, sino yung favorite cartoon character nyo? Who likes Elsa and Anna sa Frozen? Sino nakapanood na nun? Wow, very good. Napanood na nila. Maganda ba si Elsa at Anna? Maganda. May mabait ba sila? Opo. How about the boys who like Spider-Man? Wow, Batman! Superman! Ang daming gusto sa kanila because they are superhero. Why you like them the most? Do you like them because they are brave? Yes. Do you like them because they are genius? Yes. Really, they are superheroes. Who wants to be a superhero? How about the girls? Who wants to be a cartoon character like Elsa and Anna ng mga mababait? Okay, very good. Hands down. You will really, no? You will really become a superhero because of your character. You need to be kind. You need to be brave. You need to be genius. And how can you do that possible? You can do it possible if you will study harder. If you will listen to your mom, you can be a superhero. Okay? So, and because we know you can be stronger, you can be brighter, and you can be graceful like Anna and Elsa. Just believe in yourself. Everybody say, I believe in myself. Wow, very good. And when you believe in yourself, you can be a future mayor. Who wants to be a mayor? A president. Wow. How about, oh, ibabataw ang kamay din. How about teacher? Wow. How about, oh, baba ang kamay. How about doctor? Uy, madami din. How about a nurse? Uy, madami. So marami silang trabaho. How about seaman? Uy, engineer, policeman, ay, ang dami. Okay, palakpakan natin yung mga kids. Because you know what? They have dreams. They have these dreams that they want to be like that someday. Because they believe in their self. And when you do, okay, you will be their parents to assist these children. And who wants to be a superhero again? You say, I am a superhero. I am a superhero. Yes, ako din superhero din ako. Ako si Princiderella. Okay, ako si Princiderella. Okay, and how to be a superhero? How? Everybody say, number one! Okay, number one, listen to your parents. Who are listening to their parents? Asang kamay? Pag sinabi ng mama, matulog na, sino matutulog ka agad? Well, very good. Sino na mag-listen kay teacher, kay mama at papa pag sinabi, kumain ka na ng gulay? Awa, ang iba hindi talaga kumakain, hindi po nakaano. Okay, yes, that is correct, children. You need to listen to your parents. Respect and love your parents with all your heart. While you are learning, kids, it is good to have good values and you can get that from your parents. You should not separate being good and being wise. It should always be together, being good and being wise. Number two, everybody say, do not be shy. Huwag mahiya. Do not be shy. Like these two lovely masters of ceremony. They are not afraid. They are not shy. They are ready to face the audience. They are brave. So please follow them. If your teacher teaches you to read, to write, to sing and dance, try it. You need to try it so that you can practice and you will not be shy. And everybody say number three. Okay, number three, always pray. Sino ang nag-pray always? Sino ang nagpa-pray always? Wow, very good. Are you praying before you eat your breakfast? Very good. Are you praying after you have eaten your meal? Very good. Are you praying before you go to sleep? Wow. How about if you wake up in the morning? Are you still praying? Wow, very good. Palakpakan natin yung always mag-pray. So that is number three. You should always pray. Because you know what? God is listening to your prayer. God loves little children like you. So God will answer your prayer. Do not stop praying. And those three that I have mentioned a while ago are the three tips that I have followed and I am still following. And that is why I am here in front of you and I am still dreaming of something great things that would happen in my life. So kids, please follow the tips that I have given to you. So to all who are here today, you are the witness on the first moment that these children believe that they can be a superhero. There is nothing we can do but to guide them with our love and care. Let these completers today, the movers today, pursue their dreams and foster their resiliency and toughness in times of difficulties. So once again, thank you and congratulations to one and all.